Hello and good evening from Haven Center at Benilde St. Margaret's. I'm Bruce Overin. Tonight it's the St. Louis Park Orioles against the Benilde St. Margaret Red Knights, an inner city matchup as both teams from St. Louis Park. Always a little bit of a rivalry here. And the starting lineups for the St. Louis Park Orioles, who come into this game at 10-4, will be number one, Mykel Howard, a sophomore. Our junior actually averaging 10 points per game. Number five, Kyrie Mayfield. He's a sophomore averaging 13 points per game. Number 15, Josiah Morrow. He's a junior averaging 8 points per game. Number 25, Ray Whitlock, the only senior in the starting lineup for the Orioles. He's averaging 13 points per game. And number 51, Ryan Dahmers, the 6'4" junior. He's averaging 11 points per game. So the Orioles with four players in double digits. For the Red Knights, it'll be number 22, Sam Baker, 6'4" senior, averaging 16 points per game. Number 24, Derek Dries, the 6'5" junior, averaging 11 points per game. Number 33, Eli Cave, averaging 14 points per game. Number 34, Matt Lilienthal, averaging 8 points per game. And number 35, Joe Dunn. He's a 6'5" sophomore, averaging 7 points per game. John Moore not here today as the head coach of the Red Knights. He's been coached since 1974. He's out sick. We wish him the best. St. Louis Park is coached by Dave Breitenbucher. Coach's assistant for Benilde is Mike Swan and Nick Tivisar. Shot put up. It was Kyrie Mayfield getting the two to start the game. So the Orioles on board quickly. They're in the white uniforms. Benilde St. Margaret's in the red. Will Whitmore out tonight with a bad ankle for the Red Knights.
And
Eli Cave, senior, getting the three-point shot from the outside. Red Knights now lead 3-2. Orioles in the front court. This is Whitmore. Mykel Howard, now Morrow. Morrow tries to drive in, back out to Whitmore. St. Louis Park coming off a 90-45 win against Bloomington Kennedy as Whitmore hits a three, or Whitlock. So Whitlock, with his first 3 points of the game, he's Laura's leading scorer at 13 points per game. Baker. Shot off the front of the rim. Rebound pulled down by the Red Knights. So they'll keep the basketball in the front court. There's a three put up and in by Derek Dries. So a pair of threes for the Red Knights here in the early going. And they now lead 6-5 over the St. Louis Park Orioles. And for the Red Knights, they come into this game with a five-game winning streak. Their last win, a 45-44 win against Jefferson. That time Mayfield took it to the basket and dished it off. He may have been able to take it right to the hoop that time, but elected to pass instead. It was deflected off of the Red Knights. So the Orioles will have the basketball, and this is Morrow, Howard, Whitlock, and now Mayfield. Morrow likes to put up the three. This time he lobs it into Dahmers, but too far on the lob, and the ball will get turned over to the Red Knights. 16-19 to go here in the first half. 6-5 our score. Expect a good matchup, as you mentioned. St. Louis Park 10-4, Red Knights 9-4. We look at same games. Both teams actually beat Mound West Tonka by 37 points. If that tells you how close this game hopefully will be. Referees conferring with each other, and they're going to change the call. So it'll be St. Louis Park Oriole basketball. See, Baker shot a little too strong on that one. And Dahmers hits the two for the Orioles. No foul called on the drive. Good block. It was Mykel Howard on the block. Whitlock down quickly. Dahmers, Howard, and they push it across. Morrow with the three. Orioles with really good ball movement this time, and they're hitting their shots. Work it inside. Dunn. And a foul on the St. Louis Park Orioles, the dismay of the Oriole fans. So Kyrie Mayfield gets called for his first foul of the game, only the first team foul. Baker trying to drive in, and he's fouled on the drive. This one is going to be on Whitlock. So Orioles picking up two quick fouls here. Eli with the drive. Now we have an injured player. Ray Whitlock goes out. Looks like he may have a bloody nose. So Richard Green will come into the game for the St. Louis Park Orioles. Orioles will go nine deep. Red Knights typically haven't subbed that much this season, so they'll play six, maybe seven, if the game's close, and the Orioles again will go nine, maybe 10. Michael Howard with the drive and a foul. Foul on Cave, his first foul, first team foul for the Red Knights. Michael Howard to the line. And he makes the free throw. 13-8, St. Louis Park Orioles by five. Baker guarded by Richard Green. Lilienthal back out. Now Cave fakes the three. It's guarded by Dahmers. Good ball movement. Dunn doesn't get the shot to go. Nice rebound by Baker. Won't go. Baker again just off the iron. And a quick pass into the front court. Howard, whoa, what a great pass. Great look by Howard. And Mayfield finishes. Orioles had a number of fast breaks against Kennedy, and Mayfield was the benefactor of a number of those. This shot too far by Cave. And here's a steal by Cave. And a dunk. So Eli Cave turned it over, but came back with the steal in the basket. A couple players ready to check in for the Red Knights. Kyrie Mayfield almost losing it. Orioles reverse the basketball. Green. Now Morrow trying to drive in. Mayfield had to reach for that one. Now up top for Howard. Guarded by Cave. Here's Green as Howard goes to the corner. Comes back up top. Mayfield hits a long two. 17-10, Orioles with the lead. The steal. Here's the three up and out. Howard, nice spin move. Four on one break. And Green draws the foul.
Call number 24, Derek Dries, his first team
second. Derek Dries called for the foul. So Richard Green to the line. Michael Wexler comes into the game, number 14. also number 20, Peyton Miller. Wexler with the basketball, and now Baker. Baker guarded by Dahmers. Long shot by Baker. Off the iron, Joey Whitlock into the front court. Cross court pass, Green has trouble handling it, but gets the ball back. Whitlock, now Green. Green trying to clear out the zone. Kyrie Mayfield with a nice shot. Kyrie Mayfield feeling it in this game. He's got 8 points so far here in the first half. We still have 11:50 to go. Ray Whitlock ready to come back into the game for the Orioles. Baker, cross court. Wexler driving down the lane. Puts a shot up just off the iron and ...21-10, Orioles with an 11-point lead. Cave definitely size advantage against Green here. But Green with the nice move, gets it inside. Dahmers draws the foul. It's Peyton Miller picking up the foul. Dahmers missed the free throw. So Ray Whitlock replaces Morrow in the game. And Dahmers 1-2 from the free throw line there. Get a timeout. So St. Louis Park with 22 points here in the first early part of the first half. We're still 11 minutes, 9 seconds to go. As we mentioned, the St. Louis Park Orioles coming off a win against Bloomington Kennedy, 90-45. Prior to that, they had actually lost 3 out of their last 6 games, maybe 4 out of their last 7. So after starting off hot with a 6-0-6 win start, 6 in a row, they had some tough competition. And again, you know, the losses were to tough teams. They lost to Robbinsdale Armstrong, who's ranked in the top 10. They have Minnehaha Academy, Edina, they lost by 2 to Edina, and then by 4 to Bloomington Jefferson. So this is Wexler. Baker looks inside for Cave. Now Wexler. And a pushing foul called on the Orioles. So Kyrie Mayfield will have to leave the game. He picks up his second foul. He's the leading scorer for the Orioles with 8 points. Inbound pass to Cave. Cave with a nice drive. And a charge called against Cave. That's a second foul. Lorenz stacked the lane that time, and Cave just took it all the way to the hoop, drawing that foul. Richard Green loses the basketball out of bounds. Turnover for the Orioles. Gabe Alotta comes into the game. So the Red Knights have 8 players now that have played so far in this game. Also, Drees back in. Well, good defense right now. Playing that zone. Baker, been a little bit cold here in the early going. That one rolls out. Michael Howard passes out to Whitlock for the three. Doesn't go, and a good rebound by Wexler. Wexler into the front court. Nice pass, Alada. Alada will go to the line. That time, the Red Knights did a great job pushing the basketball up the court. With the basket. And Jack Lynch comes into the game, number 43 for St. Louis Park. Howard dishes off, and the basket made by Eric Anderson. So we get travel called against the Red Knights. Point St. Louis Park lead. Howard into the front court. He loses the basketball, taken away by Baker. Ball out of bounds. It'll be Red Knights basketball. They're down to 9:13 remaining here in the first half. Wexler guarded by Joey Whitlock. Good first step by Baker. Sam Baker will be attending Winona State. Congrats to Sam on his decision. Anderson can't get it to go. Lynch with the rebound is good. So a couple of juniors, Lynch and Anderson. St. Louis Park, a pretty young team. Comprised of mostly juniors and sophomores. Alada had the lane stopped by Lynch. Keeping the Red Knights along the perimeter right now. As it scored 26-14. Now inside, good pass. And a good finish by Gabe Alada. So Alada with his fourth point of the game, 26-16. Whitlock. And we're gonna get an offensive foul called against the St. Louis Park Orioles. So Eric Anderson picks up his second foul. That's a fifth team foul. Orioles will bring some of their starters back in the game. Morrow and Dahmer's back in. Cave guarded by Lynch. Back to Wexler. Baseline was blocked off by Morrow. Back to Cave. Now across Lilienthal. Up top, Wexler hits the three. So Michael Wexler with his first 3 points of the game. And it's stolen by Wexler. Here comes Wexler, pass for Alada. He loses the basketball, gets it back. Here's Cave, cross-court pass, Wexler. Right now, Red Knights are moving it well. The Whitlock comes up with the steal. And he palms the basketball coming down the court. I think he saw how fast the Red Knights were closing on defense. And that time carried the ball. Or a lead cut to seven. Here's Wexler, puts up the three, it's good. Michael Wexler feeling it right now. Trying to get his team pumped up. Orioles in a little bit of a drought right now. Dahmers tries to take it to the basket, and he gets that one to go. 5 points in the game for Ryan Dahmers. Cave trying to take it all the way, and it's going to be a charge. That's going to be his third foul. That's a tough one for the Red Knights. But that's the second time that he's gone hard to the basket. He didn't like that call, but. Almost a steal that time by Alada. Alada's added some energy since he's come into this game. And that's thrown away. Again, great defense by Alada. Green and Whitlock will come in, replacing Lynch and Michael Howard. A second attempt by Gabe Alada, and he'll go to the free throw line. So the Red Knights just struggling a little bit, getting that ball to fall. They've had some good opportunities. A couple of those just rimming in and out. And now Alada, after Dahmers picks up the foul. First foul of the game for Dahmers. Alada 3 for 3 from the free throw line. So the once 11-point lead is now cut to 4 as the Red Knights have closed the gap. Picked up their defensive pressure. Dahmers spin move. And a nice move by Dahmers. Did a good job not to get called for traveling. Baker loses the basketball. Whitlock. And the shot won't go, but a foul is going to be called on the Red Knights. So Lilienthal picks up the foul, his first foul. Both teams now with 16 fouls. That's going to send Ray Whitlock to the line. Whitlock with 3 points so far in this basketball game. So 4 straight points for the St. Louis Park Orioles. The lead back up to 8, 32-24. And a pass too far that time for Dries. Almost stolen by Baker. Whitlock into the front court. Stops the dribble, gets it over to brother Ray. Joey Whitlock, turnarounder, not good. Morrow fights for the rebound, has it. And the Orioles will bring it back out. Richard Green will take it. Whitlock takes it to the basket. And a great move by Ray Whitlock. Seven in the game for Ray. Here's a three put up. It's good. Derek Dries with a second three. Had a great look to the basket that time. Put it in. 34-27. Whitlock down the lane. Nice pass off. And Dahmers with the finish. Doesn't take long for Dries to put up a three. The Red Knights move it quick. Long pass. Here's Morrow. Does a good job to maintain possession. Finishes the basket. And the Orioles now back up by 11. So it's just down to four. You can see how fast the Orioles can score. It's an important part of the game for the Red Knights. They lose the basketball. Whitlock takes it all the way. It was blocked. And a foul called. No goaltend, though. So Alada picks up the foul. This will be a two-shot foul for Whitlock, who hit two free throws his last time at the line. Michael Wexler comes back into the game, replacing Alada. Michael hit a pair of threes to get the bring the Red Knights back into the game. They bring him back in, hoping he still can maintain that hot shooting touch. Orioles by 13, 40-27. Nice pass inside. Lilienthal finishes. That was set up on a nice drive by Joe Dunn. Dished off to Lilienthal, and Lilienthal with his first 2 points of the game. Morrow penetrates in, out to Whitlock. Kyrie Mayfield. Now Joey Whitlock. That one rolls out. Whitlock had a good look at it. Inside, Dunn. And the foul. So Dahmers picks up his second foul. That's going to probably earn a seat for him on the bench. Back in the game. Dunn with a pair of free throws. So far, the Red Knights are 6 for 6 from the free throw line. They trail by 9. Michael Howard wants the ball in the corner. Is it Mayfield back to Howard? Orioles can be patient here. Trying to get the Red Knights to come out. Orioles taking time off the clock. Trying to get the Red Knights to move out of their zone. Nice drive, penetrate, wouldn't go. Dish back out, Mayfield. That one won't go, it's batted around. Baker has it, has Dunn, and Dunn finishes. Back to a 7-point game. Mayfield not taking the three. Earl's making the Red Knights chase right now. Down a minute 13. Whitlock now with 54 seconds. Challenging the Red Knights to come out. Now we're down to 30, so maybe the Orioles will go for one now. Orioles have held the ball for over a minute. Now they're 12 seconds, 11. Whitlock with 7. Joey Whitlock off his foot, and the Orioles won't get a shot out of this one. So the Orioles take a lot of time off the clock, but get nothing to show for it. But a good half for the St. Louis Park Orioles against the Red Knights. And we're through one half of play here from Haven Center and Benilde St. Margaret's. The score of the St. Louis Park Orioles 40, the Red Knights 33. We'll be back in just a minute.
Drownings are a leading cause of death for young children. Simple safety steps are the best way to prevent these tragedies. Make sure kids learn how to swim. Always watch them in and around water. Properly fence all pools and stay away from drains. Consider the steps you take, then add a few more. Because you never know which pool safety step will save a life until it does. Simple steps save lives. To learn some new ones, visit poolsafely.gov.
Hello, I'm Bruce Holmer. We're back at Haven Center. St. Louis Park Orioles lead 40-33 over the Benilde St. Margaret Red Knights. And scoring in that first half for the St. Louis Park Orioles, Dahmers and Whitlock each had 9. Mayfield with 8. We had Howard with 3. Green with 2. Lynch with 2. And Anderson with 2 for the Benilde St. Margaret Red Knights. The leading scorer was Cave with 7. Dries, Wexler and Alada had 6. We had Dunn with 4. Baker with 2. And Lilienthal with 2. Dunn, the ball is tipped by Dries. Dries gets the ball back. Puts it up and in. Good hustle by Dries. His 8th point of the game. And Whitlock hits the 3 for the St. Louis Park Orioles. Cave back in the game with 3 fouls. He's got to be careful. A couple of those offensive fouls in the first half. Dunn. Lilienthal. Dunn. Now stolen away. Orioles with a 3-on-1. Pass is broken up nicely by Baker. Great job, and he sees Cave open, and a good foul by Whitlock. Not letting Cave go in for the 2. I think Cave saw the dunk opportunity that time. He's smiling.
Foul number 25, Ray Whitlock, his second.
So Whitlock picking up his 2nd foul. Coach Brighton Bucher not happy on that last pass, but turned the ball over. First miss of the night for the Red Knights from the free throw line. They're 7 of 7. Morrow launches a 3. That was off the mark. And the rebound by Lilienthal. Baker. Sam cross court. Cave trying to direct some traffic. Now Cave penetrates in, gets it out. The shot by Dunn would not go. Orioles into the front court with Whitlock. Takes it all the way to the basket. Now dishes off. That was a great job by Whitlock. Thought he was going to shoot it. Instead, he got penetrated in far enough, and good break to the basket by Morrow to finish. Foul on the drive by Lilienthal. He's going to go to the free throw line. We'll see if they call this one on Dahmers. If it is, yes, it is. It's his third foul.
Foul number 51, Ryan Dahmers, his third, team second.
Dahmers has had some games where he gets in foul trouble. Orioles need him on the court. Pair of free throws by Lilienthal. We're going to see Anderson coming in replacing Dahmer. Eric Anderson had 2 points in the first half. Mayfield takes it all the way to the hoop. Didn't get it to go. It ran into Baker there. Baker with the rebound. Nice pass inside, and the Red Knights score and a foul. So the Red Knights on a run can close the gap to four.
Foul number 44, Eric Anderson, his third team.
So the free throw by Dunn. Anderson picks up his third foul. So both big guys, Anderson and Dahmers, with three fouls. That's going to bring Lynch into the game. Morrow drives in, has a block. Good save. That was Michael Howard. Kyrie Mayfield back up top. Whitlock, nice pass inside. Lynch. That was great movement by the Orioles. Set up on a nice save by Lynch, or by Michael Howard, excuse me. This is Baker, guarded by Whitlock. Dunn almost loses the basketball, got it back. Long cross-court pass, this is Cave. Goes the other direction, here's Baker, hits a three.
Sam Baker!
Watch out, if Sam heats up, that'll be trouble for the Orioles. 3-point game. Morrow drives in, had it blocked by Cave. Michael Howard tries to get around, and he does. Michael Howard sort of with the dish around Cave. Breeze loses the basketball. This is Howard going in for the basket. Cave's got to be careful, and now we get a reach-in foul that's going to be called on Mayfield, I believe, and if that is, it's his third. So that'll bring Richard Green into the line as three Orioles have picked up their third foul. Again, this is the strength of the St. Louis Park Orioles team, is that they can go deep onto the bench. Baker had the hot hand. We'll see if on the last shot with the three, we'll see if he gets the basketball, see if they work it to him. Here's Baker. Sam brings it back out. Whitlock went for the steal. Sam hits it off the backboard and in. Cal Howard dishes one go, and the block. That was Dunn who came up with the block. Here's Baker. Nice pass. That was a good no-looker to Alada. couldn't get it to go. Gets the second shot. Orioles long pass. And the finish by Michael Howard is just waiting down there as a wide receiver for the pass. 53-47, Orioles by six. Red Knights so close. Here's Baker putting up the three. That one a little short. Deflected out of bounds. The Red Knights basketball.
Joey Whitlock entering for the Orioles.
Whitlock comes in for the Orioles. And foul for the Orioles.
Foul number 25, Ray Whitlock is third.
So now Ray Whitlock has three fouls. Fouls here in the second half. Five team fouls for the St. Louis Park Orioles. Zero for the Red Knights. Wexler takes it in. Richard Green with the rebound. Whitlock takes it like a football as he carried it in there. Had too much steam, was unable to get that shot. Probably not a wise play. And now Whitlock with the steal, and he drops it in over the front of the basket. 14. Every time Benil makes a run, the Orioles come back. Cave all the way in. Great drive by Eli as he saw an opening up the middle. Orioles ready to bring Dahmers and Howard back into the game. Green carried by Wexler. Joey Whitlock. Now Morrow. Morrow takes it all the way in. Blocked by Cave. Eli Cave with like his third block of the game. Almost steps on the sideline there. And travel called on Baker. So the Red Knights turn it over with 11:07 to go here in the game. And Kyrie Mayfield brings it in the front court. Dahmers and first foul of the second half called on the Red Knights is going to be called on Alada.
Foul number 21, Gabe. His second.
So that's Gabe's second foul. Derek Dries back in for the Red Knights. St. Louis Park leading by six. Wexler comes out on Green. Green takes it all the way to the basket, avoids the block, but Dries comes away with the basketball and the missed shot. You definitely see the height advantage for the Red Knights. Zorio's trying to penetrate inside. Hasn't worked. Nice steal by Green. Two-on-one break off the foot of the defender and a great save. Red Knights lose the ball now. And Green finishes. Both teams scrappy on defense, causing some turnovers here. Nice pass. That was Wexler with the great dish, but shot didn't go. Trap in the backcourt, and now the Orioles into the front court. Whitlock. Green. Here's Dahmers, guarded by Cave. Can't take it in. Cave with the block. Good job by Cave not to pick up his fourth foul. And now he takes it to the basket. Not going to go as it's ball stuck between the rim and the backboard. You need someone who can get up there, and that's Baker. So Dahmer's. Again, Cave is just taking it hard to the hoop. He's drawn a couple of charges, but he's also picked up a number of fouls against the St. Louis Park Orioles big guys. Great 11 points in the game for Cave.
Timeout, Red Knights.
And the Red Knights will take a timeout as they lead 57-50. You see the St. Louis Park Orioles with Coach Brighton Bucher. As we mentioned, St. Louis Park coming into this game 10-4. Their wins this season over Kennedy, West Tonka, Irondale, Richfield, Cambridge, Ossanee, Hastings, Eastridge, Simley, Roseville, and Park Center. For the Red Knights, their wins as they're 9-4 against Bloomington, Jefferson, Shaska, Mound, West Tonka, De La Salle, Moorhead, Casson, Manorville, Waconia, Holy Angels, and Rosemont. The four losses for the Red Knights: South, Minneapolis South, Edina, Orono, and Robbinsdale Cooper. Cooper, the St. Louis Park Orioles' next opponent, that being Friday night. It's been a very good free throw shooting night for the Red Knights. I think they've just missed one so far in the game. And Kyrie Mayfield picks up the foul.
Foul number 21, Gabe
Alada. The foul on Alada, his third foul. Orioles 9 of 10 from the free throw line, so they've also had a good free throw shooting night. And Mayfield hits a pair. Kyrie Mayfield with 10 points so far in this game. Wexler hit a couple threes in the first half, been quiet here in the second. Alada, Cave. Eli hit a three early too in the game, and most of his has come from inside now. Good spin move to the basket by Cave. Orioles are in a situation where they can't foul too, so Cave can just keep penetrating to the basket. 59-53, 6-point Oriole lead. That's a long one, and it's good by Green. Richard Green launched that one well beyond the arc. Back to 9 points. Here's Alada, Baker, now Wexler. Wexler guarded by Green. Looks across court. Grease spins. Now the pass inside. Cave. Orioles don't have an answer for Cave. Alada deflects it out of bounds, out of the hands of Whitlock. Orioles basketball, and Josiah Moore will come back into the game now, replacing Lynch. Orioles having trouble getting it in. Moore has it. Good defense now by the Red Knights. Richard Green. Driving to the basket is Whitlock. Green got up high for that rebound. Tough bounce by Green, and we're going to get a foul. Looks like some elbows there. Looked like on the rebound there's some elbows flying and no call. Call went against actually the Orioles, so. Coach Breitenbucher, a little upset with that one. And Morrow hitting the three for the Orioles. What we're seeing right now is some easy baskets by the Red Knights, and the Orioles still maintaining that lead. Third foul for the Red Knights. And for Lilienthal, that's his second foul. Orioles have six fouls, so one more, and the Red Knights will be in the bonus. 7:08 remaining here in regulation time. Richard Green to the line. Now 2 for 3 from the free throw line. To mention again that John Moore out sick tonight. We want to wish him our best. It's well soon here, and Gabe Alotta has 10 points in this game. He's played well. Gabe Alotta only a sophomore. Harry Mayfield shot didn't go. And nice rebound by Whitlock. His shot won't go. Here comes Baker. Morrow, it's deflected by Alotta. Batted out of bounds, and it's going to be Red Knights basketball.
Ryan Dahmers in for the Orioles.
So now Dahmers comes in with four fouls. And if, see if Cave goes right again, right after him. Lilienthal, and this time they get the roll as Greaves finishes it up. Now 5-point game. This is Morrow up top for Whitlock. Whitlock hasn't been able to get his shot off in this game too often. There he. Short on that one. Here's Cave. Driving Lilienthal, dishes for Alotta. And the basket. Orioles need a timeout here. As the Red Knights have closed the gap to three. Hasn't been at 3 points since early in the game. We see the great look, the great pass. Dahmers unable to get his hand on that one as he was inside, and Dahmers has to be careful too. He can't defend with four fouls or he'll be out of the game. Still 5:48 to go. Red Knights with a little bit of momentum here. Next game for the Benilde St. Margaret Red Knights will be Friday, January 15th at home against Chanhassen. Then they go on the road for a couple as they head to Duluth East. At the UMD campus. That game Monday, January 18th. in Tuesday, January 19th at Richfield. So a little bit of driving for this team. Next game for the St. Louis Park Royals at home against Robbinsdale Cooper. Then they head out to Chanhassen. Royals led by 7 after the first half. Here's Whitlock. This is a shot, nice rebound. Mayfield, and he gets it to go. Kyrie Mayfield. Here's Baker for 3. Sam Baker with the 3. 11 points in the game for Baker. It's now a 2-point game. Dahmers. Mayfield, cross for Morrow. His shot doesn't go. Cave with the rebound, and now the Red Knights can either tie or take the lead with the basket here. This is Dries, puts up the 3 for the lead. It doesn't go off for the Red Knights. St. Louis Park basketball. Under 5 minutes remaining. We knew this one would be a close one, and it's as close as it's been right now at 2 points. Michael Howard, nice drive. '70-'66. Baker, foul on the drive. So Baker will be on the 1-1. It's going to be on Whitlock. That's number 4.
Foul number 25, Ray Whitlock. His 4th, team 7th.
See if the Orioles leave Ray in the game with 4 fouls. Miss front end of the 1-1. What a drive. Montel Howard taking it to the hoop. Says, give me an opportunity. This game's too close. And he's got 2 baskets in a row. Draws the foul. '14 in the game for Howard. 3-point play gives the Orioles a 7-point lead. 73-66, under 4 minutes. Orioles with a couple players in foul trouble. And Whitlock with 4, Dahmers with 4. Cave fakes the 3. He's going to take it to the hoop against Morrow. Batted around. Mayfield with the basketball. Long pass. This is Whitlock. And Whitlock closes. Mayfield tried to get, or Baker trying to get the block. Here's a steal, here's Whitlock. And Whitlock with 2 straight baskets, and the Orioles with the big run here. Boy, the Orioles are relentless. Just when we saw the Red Knights cut it to 2, St. Louis Park goes on a 9-0 run, and it's 77-66. As we see Whitlock. When you get teams that can run with the basketball, it doesn't take long to put points on the board. And we saw the Red Knights coming back with some quick baskets, closing the gap, and now the Orioles on a bit of a run here. 3:18 remaining. Red Knights in the bonus. Orioles have committed 7 team fouls here in the second half. Red Knights with 4. Conference standings. Not many teams have played many conference games. Cooper leads the conference with a 2-0 record. The Red Knights are 2-1 along with Chaska and St. Louis Park. Chanhassen 1-1, Jefferson 1-2, Richfield 1-2, and Kennedy 0-3. Red Knights with the basketball as we're getting down to close to 3 minutes remaining. Baker gets Howard away from him, and the rebound was pulled down by Whitlock. And we're down to 3 minutes. The Orioles took time off the clock in the first half. We'll see if they, at the end of the first half, see if they like to try and run time now. Whitlock, now Dahmers. Down to 2.5 minutes. So the Orioles ran 40 seconds off the clock. You could say that the Red Knights have fouls to give. And Baker with the steal, that's what they were looking for. Baker can't finish. Another chance that doesn't go. Drees has it stolen by the Orioles. Boy, the Red Knights just couldn't capitalize there, and the foul on Cave is 4th. Cave had 3 fouls in the first half and was able to stay foul-free here in the second half until that one. Well, the Red Knights really needed that basket by Baker, and it just didn't go. And it was great hustle by Sam to get the basketball as St. Louis Park was taking time off the clock. Sometimes when you do that, you get out of your rhythm. And you see, sometimes that can come back to haunt a team when the other team starts coming back, and now you got to try and get back in your rhythm again. But for the Orioles, feeling that they're up by 11, time is of the essence, and taking a little bit of time off the clock. 5 fouls for team fouls for the Red Knights, so they still have another foul before St. Louis Park gets in the bonus. St. Louis Park in the game from the free throw line is 12 of 14. So it may come down to St. Louis Park, what they can do at the free throw line here in the fourth or second half. We don't have quarters anymore here. For the Red Knights, it's a lot of Baker, Drees, Lilienthal, and Cave. For the Orioles, it's Mayfield, Howard, Whitlock, Morrow, and Dahmers. And the quick foul. So now the next one, St. Louis Park, will be in the bonus. Michael Howard with the basketball, guarded by Alada. So they're fouling right now. That's their plan, is to foul to get back in this game. Michael Howard will go to the free throw line.
Foul number 21, game
Alada has fouled out of the game. Twelve points in the game for Alada. Gabe didn't start the game, but he came in and he played well.
And
So Michael Wexler will replace a lot in the game. All important front end of the 1-1, and Michael Howard converts that one. 15 points. Michael Howard and Ray Whitlock have done a great job when Red Knights were coming back. Michael Howard took it to the basket, had a few nice driving, running floaters for baskets. And now Baker's shot won't go. Maybe trying to do too much that time. Long pass, here's Mayfield, and he finishes. That's the strength of Kyrie's game, is on the break. He's able to finish. Orioles up by 15. And Cave doesn't go. Dahmer's with the rebound. And now the Orioles can try and take time off the clock, but they're going to get the foul on Dries. It's going to send Michael Howard to the line where he's 4 of 4.
Foul number 24, Derek Dries, his third.
Should mention again, the Red Knights playing without Will Whitmore with a sprained ankle, and that is a injury that is costly. Whitmore averaging 8 points per game. But again, he's done a great job for the Red Knights this season. Cave penetrates into the lane for the basket. Orioles got to get it into the front court. Howard finds Whitlock, who alertly takes it back out. Orioles feel it's most important to take time off the clock, and that's what they're going to do, and it's going to be the ninth foul on the Red Knights. Still the 1-1, but one more foul, Orioles will go to the line shooting two. Richard Green, now 4 of 5 from the line. He has 9 points in the game. That rolls in and out. 14-point game, under a minute to go. Cave gets the roll. It's gonna be a long two for Cave. Orioles take a timeout with 48 seconds to go. What a great game by played by the St. Louis Park Orioles, and a lot of credit for the Red Knights too. They fought hard, got back into this game, cut it to two, and it looked like they had the momentum. And then St. Louis Park all of a sudden went on a run, and now lead 82-70. So the 12-point game probably, you know, the game maybe a little bit closer, but some of those runs and quick baskets giving the Orioles a 12-point lead. And Coach Breitenbucher has to be happy with the way his team's played. They had a couple tough losses in close games, ones that he felt they could have won against Jefferson, where they lost 70-66, and especially Edina 74-72, games where they went down to the wire. And so when he sees the Red Knights close the gap to two and sees Orioles come back, that's got to be a good feeling for him. Orioles into the front court. Dahmer's going to get fouled with 40 seconds to go. Ryan Dahmer's did a good job to stay in this game as long as he did after being in foul trouble. Ryan with 10 points in the game. Now 2 of 3 from the free throw line. So 11 for Ryan. 84-70, down to 35 seconds. Eli Cave, he'll take the three, he hits it. Eli, a great-looking basketball player. Fun to watch him develop over the years. Trap. Orioles get it out. And now the Red Knights. See if they slide. Oh, they're going to get a foul on Baker. Whitlock will go to the line. 12 and a half seconds to go. 84-73. Whitlock looking for his 19th point. Couple of threes, four field goals, some free throws, and a 19-point performance for Ray Whitlock. And this should be the last drive down the court. They're going to give it to Baker, who couldn't finish. Now Baker gets it to go. Sam's had some of those that have just rimmed in and out, and the Orioles will run the clock out.
Final score is 85.
So 85-75, the final score. A great game by a number of players for the St. Louis Spark Orioles. Ray Whitlock with 19 points. Dahmer's had 11. Richard Green, 9 points. Michael Howard, a great second half, and I think he had 3 in the first half. Ended up with 16, so 13 second half points for Michael Howard. Kyrie Mayfield, who had an 8-point first half, ended up with 14 points. Josiah Morrow had 10 points. Lynch with 4, Eric Anderson with 2. Sam Baker had 3 3-pointers. 13 points for Sam. He just had some bad luck with a number of balls that just didn't finish, that just in and out. And Sam, a leader on the court, played, I thought, still played a strong game. For the Red Knights, Dries with 10 points. Eli, 23 points for Eli Cave, so a nice strong performance by Cave. Joe Dunn with 7 points, I believe, and Matt Lilienthal 4. Gabe Alotta came into the game, had a strong game. He had 12 points. Michael Wexler was couple threes in the first half for 6. So good game here tonight from Haven Center, Benilde. On behalf of myself, Bruce Overman, I want to thank everyone for joining us. Again, the final score here is the St. Louis Park Orioles 85, the Red Knights 75. And the Orioles now go to 11-4. The Red Knights now 9-5. So long, have a great night.